Hello and welcome. In this particular video, we will discuss about constituent assembly. As you people must be knowing that this lecture series is very important for UPSC, CAPF, CDS and NDA and all other exams which will be having polity as a subject. In 1934, the idea of constituent assembly for India was put forward for the first time by M.N. Roy, a pioneer of the communist movement in India, in the year 1935 for the first time in a national congress. M.N. Roy did it in 1934. In 1935, for the first time, International Congress officially demanded constituent assembly to frame constitution for India. So 1935 was the year when Indian National Congress demanded constituent assembly to frame constitution for India. Jawaharlal Nehru in year 1938 declared that the constitution of free India must be framed without any external interference by the constituent assembly elected on the basis of adult franchise. So in 1938, Jawaharlal Nehru declared that the constitution of free India must be framed without any external influence or interference by the constituent assembly, and which has to be elected on the basis of adult franchise. The demand was finally accepted in principle by British government in the proposal of August of 1940. So the basic demand for the constituent assembly was accepted as August offer in the year 1940. In 1942, Sir Stratford Cripps came to India with a draft proposal of British government with regard to the process of framing of an independent constitution to be adopted after World War II. The Cripps proposal was rejected by Muslim League, which wanted the division of India into two dominion state with two separate constituent assembly. So the Cripps offer, it was rejected by Muslim League. Finally, the cabinet mission was sent to India. While it rejected the proposal of two constituent assembly, it put forward the scheme for constituent assembly, which more or less satisfied the demand of Muslim League. So now we'll start with the composition of constituent assembly. The constituent assembly was assembly constituted in the year 1946 as per the scheme which was formulated in cabinet mission plan. Features of the scheme are 389 was the total strength of constituent assembly. So 389 was the total strength of constituent assembly, out of which 296 were for British India and 93 for princely states. Out of 296 seats that were allotted to British India, 292 members were to be drawn from 11 governor provinces. So out of these, 292 were to be drawn from 11 governor provinces and 4 from the chief commissioner's provinces, each princely state or provinces were to be allotted seats in proportion to their respective population. So it was, seats were allotted with respect to population. Number of seats allotted every British province were to be decided among the three principal groups, which were Sikh, Muslim and General. General included all except Sikhs and Muslim in proportion to their population. The representative of each community were to be elected by members of that community in the provincial legislative assembly, and voting was to be done by the method of proportional representation by means of single transferable vote. The representative of princely states were to be nominated by princes. So the representative of princely state were nominated. Moreover, the member were to be elected indirectly by the members of provincial assembly, who themselves were elected on the basis of limited franchise. The assembly comprises of the representative of all section of society. So the constituent assembly had representation of all sections, which includes Hindu, Muslims, Sikh, Parsi, Indian Christians, Anglo-Indian, scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, including women of these section. The assembly included almost all important personality of India at that time, except two, which is Mahatma Gandhi and Muhammad Ali Jinnah. These two were absent. Now we will talk about the working of Constituent Assembly. Working of Constituent Assembly. So the first meeting was held on 9th December 1946. The Muslim League boycotted the meeting and insisted on the creation of separate state of Pakistan. Thus the meeting was attended by only 211 members. So the meeting was attended by 211 members. The oldest member, Dr. Sachidanand Sinha. Was elected as a temporary president following the French practice. So the oldest member, Dr. Sachidananda Sinha, was elected as a temporary basis. So this was done following the French practice. This is important here. So temporarily, the most senior one or the most oldest member was elected. This was a French practice. Letter on 11th December 1946. Dr. Rajendra Prasad and H.C. Mukherjee was respectively elected as President and Vice President of Constituent Assembly. Sir B.N. Rao was the Constitutional Advisor. Sir B.N. Rao was Constitutional Advisor, and First President Dr. Rajendra Prasad, and First Vice President became H.C. Mukherjee. The next topic that we will talk about is objective resolution, one of the important topic here. On December 13th, 1946, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Pandit Nehru, moved a historic objective resolution in Constituent Assembly. It laid down the fundamental and philosophy of the constitutional structure. So, the objective resolution, which was drafted by or moved by Jawaharlal Nehru, laid down the fundamental and philosophy of constitutional structure. It reads that this Constituent Assembly declares its firm and solemn resolve to proclaim India as independent sovereign republic. So here, independent, sovereign, and republic, and to draw up for the future governance a constitution wherein the territories that now comprise British India, the territories from the Indian states and such other parts of India as are outside India, and the states as well as the other territories which are willing to be constituted into independent sovereign India shall be union of all of them. Third is wherein the said territories, whether with their present boundaries or with such others as may be determined by the Constituent Assembly. And therefore, according to the law of the Constitution, shall possess and retain the status of autonomous unit together with residuary power and exercise all power and function of the government and administration, save and accept such power and functions as are vested in or assigned to Union. All power and authority of the sovereign independent India, and the state shall guarantee and secure all the people of India justice, social, political equality of status and of opportunity, and before law, freedom of thought, expression, belief, faith, worship, vocation, and association. This became a source of preamble. Other functions which was performed by Constituent Assembly. In addition to the process of drafting of the Constitution and enacting ordinary law, the Constituent Assembly also performed following functions. It ratified India's membership of Commonwealth. First, what it did, it ratified India's membership in Commonwealth in 1949. It adopted national flag 1947. It adopted national anthem 1950. It adopted national song 1950. And it elected Dr. Rajendra Prasad as first President of India on January 24, 1950. In all, the Constituent Assembly had 11 sessions over 2 years, 11 months and 18 days. So is this particular time frame important to be remembered? So the answer to this question is yes. In exams like CDS and FCAT, this type of question directly can appear in the exam. The constitution maker had gone through the constitution of 60 countries. So 60 countries. And the draft constitution was considered for 114 days. Committee of the Constituent Assemblies. So now we will talk about few committees which were there. So the constituent committee appointed a number of committees to deal with different tasks. Among these, 8 were major committees and other were minor committee. So this committee and the person or the chairman is important, and question directly appears in the exam. There will be 3 or 4 committees and their names will be there. It may be either ABCD type of question or one right or wrong question. So first is Union Power Committee or Union Power Committee. It was Nehru. Union Constitution was same Nehru. Provincial Constitution was Sardar Patel. Drafting Committee was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Advisory Committee on Fundamental Rights, Minority and Tribal and Excluded Area. Advisory Committee on Fundamental Right, Minority, etc. and Tribals. It was also under Sardar Patel. So for this committee had following subcommittees. Okay, so first is Fundamental Rights. Subcommittee on Fundamental Right was chaired by J.B. Kriplani. Minorities was chaired by H.C. Mukherjee. Northeast Frontier Tribal Area and Assam excluded the partially excluded area. This committee was chaired by Gopinath Bardoloi for Northeast Frontier Tribal Area and excluded area by A.V. Thakkar. The next major committee is Rules of Procedure. Was Dr. Rajendra Prasad. The States Committee was Nehru. Steering Committee, Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Now we will briefly discuss about the minor committee. The Committee on Function of Constituent Assembly was headed by G.V. Maulankar. Order of Business Committee was headed by Dr. K.M. Munshi. House Committee was headed by B. Pattabhi Sitaramaiah. Finance and Staff Committee was headed by Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Credential Committee was headed by Aladi Krishna Swami Iyer. Now we will discuss about Drafting Committee. Drafting Committee Among all the committees of the Constituent Assembly, the most important one was Drafting Committee, which was set up on August 29, 1947. This committee was the one entrusted with the task of preparing a draft for new constitution. It had 7 members in total. They were, first, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was the chairman. Then N. Gopal Swami Iyengar. Third was Aladi Krishna Swami Iyer. Fourth was Dr. K.M. Munshi. Dr. K.M. Munshi. Fifth was Saeed Ahmed Saadullah. Saeed Ahmed Saadullah. Sixth was N. Madhav Rao. He replaced B.L. Mittar, who resigned due to ill health, and T.T. Krishnamachari. He replaced D.P. Khaitan, who died in 1948. After giving due consideration to the proposal of various committees, the draft committee prepared the first draft of Constitution of India, which was published in February 1948. The people of India were given the period of 8 months to discuss the draft and propose amendment. In the light of public criticism, comments and suggestion, the drafting committee prepared the second draft, which was published in October 1948. Now we come to a particular part of enactment. Enactment of the Constitution. The Constitution was adopted on 26th of November 1949 with a preamble and 395 articles. So when the Constitution was adopted on 26th November 1949, it was adopted with a preamble, 395 article and 8 schedules. The preamble was enacted after entire Constitution was already enacted. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is recognized as the father of Constitution of India. The Constitution came into force on January 26, 1950. This day is referred to the Constitution as date of its commencement and celebrated as Republic Day. January 26 was specifically chosen as the date of commencement of the Constitution because it was on the day in 1930 that Purna Swaraj was celebrated, following the resolution of the Lahore session, December 1929 of INC. So 26th Jan was chosen because on this date on 1936, following the Lahore session, which was held in December 1929, Purna Swaraj Day was celebrated on this particular day. Now, after the drafting, there are some criticisms which are faced by the Constituent Assembly. So, as such, there is no question on this, or there is not a probability of asking question from this topic in prelims, but there can be an analytical question. So, we will just write down the highlights of this particular topic. So, first, it says that it is not a representative body. It is not a representative body, and it was not directly elected by the people of India on the basis of universal adult franchise. Second is not a sovereign body. Not a sovereign body, as the proposal was itself brought by British government. And third was time consuming. It is stated that American Constitution was framed only in 4 months. Fourth is dominated by Congress. Granville Austin says that the Constituent Assembly was one party body in the essential one party country. Fifth was the domination of lawyer and politician. So here the domination of lawyer and politician. There is also one criticism that it was dominated by Hindus. Lord Vincent Simon called it a body of Hindus, and even British Prime Minister Winston Churchill commented that the Constituent Assembly represented only one major community in India. In the next video, we will meet with a topic called salient feature of Indian Constitution. So stay tuned. Kindly subscribe to the channel and have a great time ahead.